This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. London has an extensive and developed transport network which includes both private and public services. Journeys made by public transport systems account for 25% of London's journeys, while private services accounted for 41% of journeys. London's public transport network serves as the central hub for the United Kingdom in rail, air and road transport. Public transport services are dominated by the Executive Agency for Transport in London. Transport for London TfL controls the majority of public transport, including the underground, buses, tramlink, the Docklands Light Railway, London River Services and the London Overground. Other rail services are either franchised to train operating companies by the National Department for Transport DfT. TfL also controls most major roads in London, but not minor roads. In addition, there are several independent airports operating in London, including Heathrow, the busiest airport in the United Kingdom. Contents 1 History 2 Metro and Light Rail 21 London Underground 22 Docklands Light Railway 23 Tramlink 3 Heavy Rail 31 Local and Regional 311 London Overground 312 Airport Services 313 Operators 32 National Intercity 33 International 4 Ticketing 5 Roads 51 Major Routes 52 Distributor and Minor Routes 53 Congestion Charge 54 Road Casualties in London 6 Cycling 7 Buses and Bus Rapid Transit 8 Taxis 81 Black Cabs and Hire Cars 82 Horse-Drawn Vehicles 83 Bicycle Taxis and Pedicabs 9 Airports 91 Airport Transit 10 Water Transport 101 River Thames 102 Canals 103 Cargo 11 Aerial Lift 12 See also 13 References 14 External links History Management of London Transport 1933-2000 Dates Organisation overseen by 1933-1947 London Passenger Transport Board London County Council 1948-1962 London Transport Executive British Transport Commission 1963-1969 London Transport Board Minister of Transport 1970-1984 London Transport Executive Greater London Only Greater London Council 1970-1986 London Country Bus Services Green Line Only National Bus Company 1984-2000 London Regional Transport Secretary of State for Transport 2000 Transport for London Mayor of London. Early public transport in London began with horse-drawn omnibus services in 1829, which were gradually replaced by the first motor omnibuses in 1902. Over the years, the private companies which began these services amalgamated with the London General Omnibus Company LGOC to form a unified bus service, the Underground Electric Railways Company of London, also formed in 1902, unified the pioneering underground railway companies which built the London Underground. In 1912, the Underground Group took over the LGOC and in 1913 it also absorbed the London Tramway Companies. The Underground Group became part of the new London Passenger Transport Board LTPB in 1933. Underground trains, buses and trams began to operate under the shorter London Transport brand name. The London Transport name continued in use until 2000, although the political management of transport services changed several times. The LPTB oversaw transport from 1933 to 1947 until it was reorganised into the London Transport Executive 1948-1962. Responsibility for London transport was subsequently taken over to the London Transport Board 1963-1969, the Greater London Council 1970-1984 and London Regional Transport 1984-2000. Following the privatisation of London bus services in 1986, bus services were spun off to a separate operation based on competitive tendering. London buses in 2000, as part of the formation of the new Greater London Authority, responsibility for London transport was taken over by a new transport authority, Transport for London TfL, which is the publicly owned transport corporation for the London region. Today Metro and Light Rail Transport for London operates three different railway systems across London. The largest is the London Underground, a rapid transit system operating on sub-surface lines and in deep level tube lines. TfL also operates the Docklands Light Railway DLR, an automated light rail system in the east of the city, and the Tramlink system. The London Underground and the DLR account for 40% of the journeys between Inner London and Outer London, making them the most highly used used systems in all of London. These three systems extend to most points of London, creating a comprehensive and extensive system. One major area missed by these systems is South London, which is dominated by a large suburban rail network. London Underground Main Article: London Underground. London Underground's Jubilee Line at Green Park Station. London Underground lines cross the city and stretch out into the suburbs, colloquially known as the Tube. The London Underground was the first rapid transit system in the world, having begun operations in 1863. More than first time in 2006, the Underground has 11 lines, most of which connect the suburbs to central London and together form a dense network in central London, linking major railway stations, central business areas and icons. The Underground serves North London much more extensively than South London. This is the result of a combination of unfavourable geology, historical competition from surface railways and the historical geography of London, which was focused to the north of the River Thames. South London is served primarily by surface railways, although it should be noted that the majority of London Underground's route length is actually on the surface rather than in tunnel, carrying nearly 50% of London's commuters. The Tube is the most heavily used mode of public transport in the area. Docklands Light Railway. Main article: Docklands Light Railway. An automated Docklands Light Railway train at Heron Quays, in the Canary Wharf Financial District. The Docklands Light Railway DLR is an automated light rail system serving the Docklands area of East London. It complements the London Underground, largely sharing its fares system and having a number of interchanges with it. The DLR serves over 101 million passengers a year and is an essential piece of infrastructure to East London. The DLR's most heavily used stations are Bank, Canary Wharf, Canning Town, Lewisham and Woolwich Arsenal. Partly thanks to the success of Canary Wharf, the system has expanded several times and now has five main branches connecting the Isle of Dogs and Royal Docks to each other and to the City of London, Stratford, Woolwich and Lewisham. South of the river, it also serves London City Airport and Stratford International. A further extension to Dagenham Dock is being proposed but is on hold for the time. Tramlink. Main article: Tramlink. A Tramlink tram on Lebanon Road in Croydon. The Tramlink is a tram and light rail system in South London. It operates in the boroughs of Croydon and Merton and has 39 stations. The system has four services: Elmers End, Croydon, Beckenham Junction, Croydon, Wimbledon, New Addington and Elmers End, Therapia Lane. In 2011, it carried over 28 million passengers, up from 18 million in 2001. The system runs on its own right-of-way, mixed-use rails and with street traffic. The network has connections with the London Underground, the London Overground and the National Rail System. There are several extensions planned for the system, such as expanding its coverage and further integrating it into the Underground system. Heavy Rail. Main article: Rail transport in Great Britain. The radial form of the London Railway Network. London is the focal point of the British Railway Network, with 18 major stations providing a combination of suburban, intercity, airport and international services. 14 of these stations are termini and 4 are through stations, and 2 others are both. Most areas of the city not served by the Underground or DLR are served by suburban heavy rail services into one of these stations. These suburban rail services are not part of transport for London apart from London Overground and TfL Rail, but are owned and operated by a number of private rail firms. The terminal-only stations are Cannon Street, Charing Cross, Euston, Fenchurch Street, King's Cross, Liverpool Street, Marylebone, Moorgate, Paddington, St Pancras, Victoria and Waterloo. The through-only stations are City Thameslink, Old Street, Vauxhall. The mixed stations are Waterloo East, Blackfriars and London Bridge. London is also linked by rail to mainland Europe by High Speed 1 through the Channel Tunnel Rail Link, branded HS1 High Speed 1. High Speed Eurostar trains serve Paris and Brussels. Eurostar's London terminus is at St Pancras International, and the HS1 route passes through Stratford International Railway Station and 2 stations in the county of Kent, Ashford International and Ebbsfleet International. Local and regional. Main article: Commuter rail in the United Kingdom. South London is covered by a large suburban network electrified with Third Rail. Here a South West Trains service stands at Chessington South Cross. London rail routes. London is the centre of an extensive radial commuter railway network which, along with Paris, is the busiest and largest in Europe, serving the surrounding metropolitan area. Each terminus is associated with commuter services from a particular segment of this area. The majority of commuters to central London, about 80% of 11 Operated by Southern running between Milton Keynes Central in the north and East Croydon in the south, a major expansion of the Thameslink route is planned 2013-18, in which a number of existing regional rail services will be redirected via the Cross London Thameslink corridor, constantly increasing pressure on the commuter rail systems and on the underground to disperse passengers from the busy terminals has led to the multi-billion pound Crossrail scheme when completed. Crossrail will add a further Cross London line passing through Paddington and Liverpool. Street construction work is currently underway, and twin 16 km tunnels are being bored underneath the city centre. New or upgraded stations will be provided at key city centre locations, linking to the underground, while most stations in central London are termini. There are a few notable exceptions. London Bridge Station has several through lines to the more central termini at Cannon Street and Charing Cross, and trains to the latter also call at Waterloo East, linked to Waterloo by a footbridge. London Bridge's through platforms are also used by the Thameslink services of Govia Thameslink Railway, which cross the city centre, calling at Blackfriars, City Thameslink, Farringdon and St Pancras. London Overground. Main article, London Overground. London Overground at Gospel Oak, running a North London line service. This forms part of London's orbital route in addition to London's radial lines and Cross London routes. There are also several orbital national rail lines connecting peripheral inner London suburbs. These lines have been under the management of TfL since November 2007 and are operated by private contract under the London Overground brand. This commuter transport is operated as a rapid transit system with high-frequency services around a circular route with radial branch lines, and is designed to reduce stress from the inner city tube network by allowing commuters to travel across London without going through the central zone. 1 London Overground was formed by joining a series of existing railway lines to form a circular route around the city and incorporates the oldest part of the underground's history, the Thames Tunnel under the River Thames, which was completed in 1843. The routes comprise the North London Line, which arcs across North London from Richmond in the west via Willesden Junction and Highbury Cross Gate and Norwood Junction, and the South London Line, which was added to the London Overground network in December 2012, completing the circuit across the South London suburbs to Clapham Junction running from Highbury Airport. Train operator Central London Station notes Heathrow. Heathrow Connect Paddington, an all-station suburban service that serves terminals 1, 2. Heathrow South West trains Waterloo to Feltham, then bus connection to Heathrow Gatwick. Gatwick Express Victoria non-stop service, sub-brand of Govia Thameslink Railway. Gatwick Thameslink St Pancras Blackfriars London Bridge Thameslink route service. Gatwick Southern Victoria semi-fast and fast service via Clapham Junction City DLR Bank, Tower Gateway, Stratford International. Stansted Stansted Express Liverpool Street Limited stop service, sub-brand of Abellio Greater Anglia. Southend Abellio Greater Anglia Liverpool Street Luton Thameslink St Pancras Blackfriars London Bridge Thameslink route service. Operators Thameslink trains run a Cross London route through central London. Unlike the Underground, which is a single system owned and operated by Transport for London, commuter railways in London are run by a number of separate train operating companies, TOCs. This results from the privatisation of British Rail in the 1990s, which split the former state railway operator British Rail into a number of smaller franchises in order to increase competition and allow railways to operate in a free market. Among the rail firms operating passenger services in London, a number are owned by foreign companies or by state-owned railways of other European countries. London Overground is contracted in a different way to other franchises in that it is operated by a private company under contract to Transport for London. Heathrow Express is also unusual in that it is not officially part of the National Rail Franchising System. Train operator franchise services parent company, owner Abellio Greater Anglia. East Anglia franchise, local and regional, commuter services to Essex, Hertfordshire and Cambridgeshire, serving Liverpool Street. Abellio C2C Essex Thameside, local and regional, commuter services in East London and South Essex, serving Fenchurch Street. National Express Group Chiltern Railways. London to Aylesbury Line, local and regional, commuter services to North West London, Buckinghamshire, serving Marylebone. Arriva East Midlands trains regional services to Corby, serving St Pancras. Stagecoach Group Thameslink. Great Northern Thameslink and Great Northern Route provides local, commuter and regional services to North London, South London, Hertfordshire, Cambridgeshire, Bedfordshire, Kent and Sussex, serving King's Cross, St Pancras, Moorgate, Blackfriars, and London Bridge. Govia Gatwick Express service to Gatwick Airport, part of Southern Franchise serving Victoria Govia Great Western Railway local and regional, commuter services to West London and the Thames Valley region serving Paddington First Group. Heathrow Connect stopping service to Heathrow Airport serving Paddington Heathrow Express, Great Western Railway joint venture Heathrow Express non-stop service to Heathrow Airport serving Paddington Heathrow Airport Holdings London Midland local and regional, commuter services to Hertfordshire, Buckinghamshire and Northamptonshire, Warwickshire and Staffordshire serving Euston Govia London Overground Rail Operations London Overground Metro service across London Arriva, MTR, joint venture of Arriva and MTR Corporation South West Trains Waterloo to Reading Line, local services to South West London and regional, commuter services to Surrey, Hampshire, Dorset. Local metro services across South East London and commuter and regional services to Kent serving London Charing Cross, London Victoria, London Cannon Street and London Blackfriars Southeastern high-speed commuter services to Kent serving London St Pancras Govia Southern local, commuter services in South London and commuter, regional services to Sussex, stopping service to Gatwick Airport, the Cross London route to Milton Keynes serving London Bridge and Victoria Govia Stansted Express Express service to Stansted Airport, part of Abellio Greater Anglia serving Liverpool Street Abellio TfL Rail local and commuter services to Gadea Park and Shenfield serving Liverpool Street MTR Corporation National Intercity East Coast 125 mph Intercity trains connect London with the East Midlands, Yorkshire, North East. England and Scotland long-distance intercity services are provided at some London rail termini because the termini and intercity routes were largely built by competing companies. Many termini serve cities in overlapping regions or different parts of the same region, Euston for the West Midlands, North Wales, North West England and Scotland St Pancras for the East Midlands and parts of Yorkshire King's Cross for the East Midlands, Yorkshire, North East England and Scotland Liverpool Street for East Anglia Paddington for South West England and South Wales International A Eurostar train at St Pancras St Pancras provides international Eurostar services via the Channel Tunnel to cities including Paris, Brussels, Lyon and Marseille, with journeys to Paris in around 2 hours 15 minutes and to Brussels in around 1 hour 50 minutes ticketing main article, Oyster Card The TfL Oyster Card electronic ticket London commuters mostly gain access to public transport services in London by using one of the intermodal travel tickets provided by Transport for London Oyster Card is a credit card-sized electronic ticket which offers almost unlimited use on the London Underground, London Overground, Docklands Light Railway, Tramlink, London Buses and National Rail services in the Greater London area. Commuters entering London from further afield may rely on the older paper travel card combined with a National Rail ticket which offers the same intermodal access but is valid at the regional railway stations not yet equipped to offer electronic ticketing. Oyster Card is generally not valid outside the London fare zones or on certain airport express services. Both Travel Card and Oyster Card fares are calculated by using a system of fare zones which divides London's transport network into concentric circles numbered 1 to 6. Individual transport operators may also offer their own ticketing and fare tariffs for travel on one mode of transport. The London Pass offers tourists visiting London a combination of the Travel Card and admissions to a number of tourist attractions for a set fee in advance. Roads London has a hierarchy of roads ranging from major radial and orbital trunk roads down to minor side streets. At the top level are motorways and grade separated dual carriageways, supplemented by non-grade separated urban dual carriageways, major single carriageway roads. Local distributor roads and small local streets. Most of the streets of central London were laid out before cars were invented, and London's road network is often congested. Attempts to tackle this go back at least to the 1740s, when the new road was built through the fields north of the city. It is now just another congested central London thoroughfare. In the late 19th and early 20th centuries, new wide roads such as Victoria Embankment, Shaftesbury Avenue, and Kingsway were created. In the 1920s and 1930s, a series of new radial roads, such as the Western Avenue and Eastern Avenue, were constructed in the new suburban outskirts of London, but little was done in the congested central area. A 1938 report, the Highway Development Survey, by Sir Charles Bressey and Sir Edwin Lutyens for the Ministry of Transport, and Sir Patrick Abercrombie's 1943 County of London Plan and 1944 Greater London Plan all recommended the construction of many miles of new roads and the improvement of existing routes and junctions, but little was done to implement the the recommendations in the 1960s, the Greater London Council prepared a drastic plan for a network of London ringways, including the construction of the London Motorway Box, which would have involved massive demolition and huge cost to bring motorways into the heart of the city. Resistance from central government over the costs and campaigns of objection from local residents caused the cancellation of most of the plans in 1973. By the end of the 20th century, policy swung towards a preference for public transport improvements, although the 118-mile 190. The A4, M4 west to Heathrow Airport and Reading, the A40, M40 west to Oxford, the M1 northwest to Luton. Congestion charge. In February 2003, TfL introduced a radical scheme to charge motorists £5 per day for driving vehicles within a designated area of central London during peak hours. The congestion charge. The politicians behind the scheme claim that it has significantly reduced traffic congestion and hence improved reliability of bus and taxi services, but this is strongly contested by the scheme's critics. The charge was increased to £8 per day on 4 July 2005. In 2007, the zone was extended into West London. On 4 January 2011, several changes were implemented based on the public consultation conducted in 2008, which included the removal of the Western extension and a charge increase from £8 to £10. Road casualties in London. The following table shows the number of casualties, grouped by severity, on the roads of Greater London, including the City of London, over recent years: 2008, 2009, 2010, 2011, 2012, 2013. 2014 2015 fatal 204 sextillion 184 quintillion 126 quadrillion 159 trillion 134 billion 132,127,136 serious 3,322 3,043 2,760 2,646 2,884 2,192 2040 1956 total 3526 3227 2886 2805 3018 2324 2167 2303 slight 24627 24752 26003 26452 25762 24875 28618 28090 grand total 28361 27979 28889 29257 28780 27199 30785 30182 cycling. Main article: cycling in London. Barclays Cycle Hire docking station in Soho Square. Over 1 million Londoners own bicycles, but as of 2008 only around 2% of all journeys in London are made by bike. This compares poorly to other major European cities such as Berlin 5%, Munich 12%, and Amsterdam 55% and Copenhagen 36%. Nevertheless, this is an 83% increase compared to that in 2000. There are currently an estimated 480,000 cycle journeys each day in the capital. The Santander Cycles, formerly Barclays Cycle Hire scheme, launched 30 July 2010, aims to provide 6,000 bicycles for rental. Bikes are available at a number of docking stations in central London. Buses and bus rapid transit. Main articles: buses in London and East London Transit. The modern Alexander Dennis Enviro 400 double-decker bus operating services on Route 139. The red double-decker London bus has entered popular culture as an internationally recognised British icon, and while the design and operation of London buses has changed over the years, the vehicles still maintain their traditional red colour. The London bus network is extensive, with over 6,800 scheduled services every weekday carrying about 6 million passengers on over 700 different routes, making it one of the most extensive bus systems in the world and by far the largest in Europe, catering mainly for local journeys. It carries more passengers than the Underground. In addition to this extensive daytime system, a 100-route night bus service is also operated, providing a 24-hour service. East London Transit is a partially segregated bus rapid transit system. The London Buses Network and East London Transit Systems are managed by TfL through its arm's-length subsidiary company, London Buses Limited, as a result of the privatisation of London Bus Services in 1985, bus operations in London must be put out to competitive tendering and routes are operated by a number of private companies, while TfL sets the routes, frequencies, fares and even the type of vehicle used. Greater London was exempted from the bus deregulation in Great Britain. Transport companies may bid to run London bus services for a fixed price for several years, with incentives and penalties in place to encourage good performance against certain criteria. The tendering system is open to transport operators from a global market, with the result that some London bus services are now operated by international groups such as RATP Group, the state-owned operator of the Paris public transport system company Route's parent company Abellio London. London London Arriva Carousel Buses Buckinghamshire Go Ahead Group CT plus Greater London HCT Group First Berkshire North London RATP Group London United West Hertfordshire Black cabs and hire cars. The iconic Hackney carriage or black cab. The iconic black cab remains a common sight. They are driven by the only taxicab drivers in the world who have spent at least 3 years learning the city's road network to gain the knowledge. All London taxicabs are licensed by TfL's Public Carriage Office PCO, who also set taxicab fares along with strict maximum vehicle emission standards. Black cabs can be hailed on the street or hired from a taxicab rank by all the mainline railway stations and around the major business, shopping and tourist centres. Taxicab fares are set by TfL and are calculated using a taximeter in the vehicle, hence the name taxicab, and are calculated using a combination of distance travelled and time. Private hire vehicles PHVs or minicabs are cars which are not licensed to pick people up on the street. They must always be booked in advance by phone or at the operator's offices. Horse-drawn vehicles. More than 70 years after horse-drawn carriages were restricted from the West End, Westminster City Council has announced that it will consider supporting applications to reintroduce them for sightseeing tours across the city. The first Hackney carriages licensed in London, in 1662, were horse-drawn vehicles, bicycle taxis and pedicabs. Pedicabs are a fairly recent addition, being mostly used by tourists and operating in the central areas. Unlike the black cab, no test of knowledge is required to operate a pedicab or bicycle rickshaw. Cambridge Trishaws Limited moved from Cambridge to London in 1998 as the first such company to work within the city. There are now 5 to 10 such companies providing competing services. The Licensed Taxi Drivers Association LTDA went to the High Court to try to force them to become licensed, but lost their case in 2004. There has been a move, led by Chris Smallwood, chairman of the London Pedicab Operators Association, to bring in more relevant legislation. Smallwood helped to draft an amendment to a bill to be put before the House of Lords that would introduce these lighter pedicab regulations. This was followed in 2005 by Transport Committee scrutiny to determine the future of the then nascent industry. This led in turn to a 2006 TfL consultation for the introduction of a licensing regime that is appropriate for pedicabs and their riders. Airports main article, Airports of London. Map of airports serving London. London's Heathrow Airport handles more international passenger traffic than any other in the world. London City Airport has a single stall runway located on a narrow strip of land with docks on both sides. London is the best served city by airports in the world with almost 150 service in London Underground's Piccadilly line, and is connected to the M4 and M25 motorways. Gatwick is just under 40 runway, considerably shorter than the other London airports, and like Stansted it caters mainly for low-cost short-haul leisure flights. RAF Northolt in West London is used by private jets, and London Heliport in Battersea is used by private helicopters. There are also Biggin Hill and Farnborough Airfield. Croydon Airport was originally London's main airport, but was replaced by Heathrow, and closed in 1959. An airfield at LYDD has been rebranded London Ashford, but currently have little traffic. In August 2009, Oxford Airport, some 95